yeah, man, this is... full name?
Luis, Coach Lou, you can call me Coach Lou. Supreme Beings, crew, NYC B-Boy to the death. This is my boy right here, Rival. Y'all don't know. It's my boy from back in the days.
Train to break is
I'm on Instagram and Facebook right now and Twitter. Check it out. Reach out to me if you have any questions. Shout out to all those who've come through my door. You know, thank you for that. My door's always open for anyone. So
yeah, like you were saying, the idea of people understanding that there needs to be an offseason.
Yeah. It's a huge, huge thing, right? You are athletes, regardless of what you may think, right? It doesn't take away of the artist form of the b-boying in you. Athletes need an off-season. You can't put your body through all this torture and not expect to take a break from it and get it prepared for the next event or the next season, let's say. You know what I mean? It's like you need to take a break from what you've been doing for X amount of time. Meditate, relax, work on your mobility, get massages, clear your mind from a bit from the dance. And there's a lot of benefits to it. Your creativity will start to open up a little bit different. Take time to do something else that will open up your creativity to the dance. But just giving your body a break from all that physical activity.
Because you said torture, right? So you, what is your specialty?
Well, I'm a movement coach. I'm a strength coach, movement coach, and I have different certifications.
And what is that?
There's neurokinetic therapy, which is manual muscle testing of certain muscles. Like if you have pain in your back, I would kind of go through a sequence of testing certain muscles, seeing if they're turned on, why they're not, and looking at the body, almost like a puzzle, and figuring out that your lower back pain could be coming from like your inner thighs not turning on, or your deep core muscles not turning on, and getting them to be a little bit more balanced, per se. You know what I mean? I'm a movement coach through FRC, which is functional range conditioning. I'm kettlebell certified. I'm a certified personal trainer. A movement screen certified. So functional movements help me look at the body in a kind of not holistic way, but like a complete picture. I mean, it's really the first assessment I do on most b-boys. It's just 7 movements to see how you're moving. It just tells me how you're moving. And basically phase 1 of my program is based off of that.
And then also NYC certified b-boy for
how long? Oh, that's right. I was a Supreme Beings whose school I'm down with. I danced for a good 10 years.
Nice.
And I got injured, and this is why I created Train to Break.
So you said torture. So how you see us, the dancers, what makes you say that torture?
Well, torture in the sense of what we're putting our joints through. Right?
Joints, all
right. Yeah, your joints, right? Like, that's what I mean by, I know torture is probably not a great word,
yeah, no,
right?
Like, but to the hard-headed b-boy, they're probably like, nah, I know what I'm doing,
so did I, okay? Like, you know what I'm saying? I did that too. Like, I was a pretty good b-boy, I had good power, like, but I destroyed my body, I put it through torture, and it's because I didn't have an understanding of preparing my body for the things I was going to do. Like, stretching is not the answer to becoming a better b-boy. Like, that's probably the last thing you should be thinking about. You know what I mean? There's certain joints in your body that are designed to move, and if they're not moving and you're putting them through certain movements, you're going to end up injured. That's just pretty much what happens.
So what's a common one that we...
We'll take one, and simply...
From your assessing of different dancers that they're just not aware of.
I'm not gonna even take it there. I'm just gonna make it as simple as looking at your wrist, right? Like, we're on our hands 99.9% of the time as a b-boy. If it's on the ground or standing
or
up,
b-girl,
right? Or standing up, right? We are on our hands. Now, if you don't have the flexibility, the mobility and flexibility, because they're two different things, they both aid each other. But if you don't have the mobility of your wrist being at 90 degrees and you're doing handstands, you're gonna be in trouble. right? Because basically what happens is if your wrist can't bend at 90 degrees, then that means your elbow is going to start to bend automatically, and then your shoulder is going to start taking on some of the load, and then your body's just going to start to cheat throughout the process, and then things start to happen. Not good things, bad things. So that's a one thing. And then there's a thing where, like, you find b-boys who are super hypermobile that should be working on specific things and not really working on a lot of things to keep their arm completely straight. Right? So there's both, well, we can look at both sides of the mobility and flexibility issue, right? If you're too flexible, you need to be getting stronger. If you're not mobile or flexible enough, you need to spend more time on preparing your joints for being on your hands, doing footwork, or doing or aerial power or anything, right? Your hands need to be able to, stabbing position is a very common position, right? For a lot of things. If your wrists do not go to 90 degrees, then you're just kind of jamming that joint throughout the years.
And that's usually what happens when like even myself, and I've heard other dancers, like, you know how sometimes they'll show you like a little bump, like, oh, what's this? Well, what's this on my wrist that I can't, you know, push it all the way down, or when I go to do my flare or put my hand down, I feel like a sharp pain.
Yeah, that's all built up from your, the torture. I'm gonna go back to the words. That's the word I've used, because that's, you know, one of the reasons why I stopped was because of my hip. And I tortured the living crap out of my hip, which prevented me from not dancing anymore. I didn't understand, right? I relayed so much on my flexibility that I wasn't preparing my joint to understand the amount of power I was putting it through, because I didn't have strength.
Can you explain that?
So it's just like, so the joint is designed to move a certain way, just like your shoulder, right? And if it doesn't, then other things start to try to become the joint, right? So it gets complicated, the joint, because there's certain muscles that stabilize the joint, and if those muscles are not strong enough, then other things start to work overtime that are not designed to work. Gotcha. In that sense, right? So my joint wasn't moving a certain way, and I kept on forcing it to do it.
So that's not good. So the fact that when we're like, throwing it, that's not good.
Yeah, no. There's things that we can do to prepare the joint for that movement.
Because I think sometimes we substitute that as we're putting in work.
No. Listen. My crew and I, back in the days, we used to have what was called a fuck it session. Like, you're trying to get a move, you don't have it, fuck it, throw it. Yeah, I would not do that anymore, right? You know what I mean?
Gotcha.
What I would do is, I would say, okay, we're going to practice this movement. Let's do X and Y. X amount of times, and then practice the drill, because you want to be doing things to aid or enhance the movement that you're trying to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, practice is important, but not as important as preparing your body for what you're about to do. If that makes sense. You know what I mean? Like, if your hip is stuck on internal rotation, so that means every time you throw a flare, your hip automatically likes to internally rotate when it should be more out here, so that your butt and your core can light up. It's very hard for you to be in the air and your hips are going this way for you to stabilize the entire body that way. So if you're throwing your flares at practice for 15 minutes and you're compensating and trying to compensate again, you're wasting so much time and energy when what you should be doing is taking a break and saying, all right, let me do this drill so that my brain can understand how to get this leg into this position. So it's what we call in the fitness industry a filler. Like, you like add something to do after a set that's gonna improve it your next set.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying?
All right.
I don't know if that makes sense, but it's just like, there's a science behind all this stuff, man. It's so important. And the beauty of it, honestly, is like, some b-boys and b-girls come to me like, oh, well, I don't know if I can't go to practice for a week. I'm like, yeah, I don't want you to practice for 4 weeks. Oh, but I don't know. I'm like, you're going to see, because we're athletes, we have an awareness that most people that we deal with in our everyday lives don't have with our bodies because of the shit we do. The body, the minute you give your body a chance to kind of step back from the dance and like introduce it to things that it's designed to be doing, and that it's, and those things that you're designed to do are going to help your dance, the minute you take a step back from it, the body rewards you a lot faster than you think. Like, you're not going to be left behind 4 weeks. Like, what catching up are you doing? Your friend didn't get better in 4 weeks. You know what I mean?
Your skills.
You just got, in those 4 weeks,
You powered up.
You went into like Gohan's chamber and like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what happened mentally and physically. Like, you get into a zone with your body where you're just like, oh, I get this. You're a fucking dancer. You're the best compensator on earth. And because of that, when we step back from the dance and we introduce you to things that are going to slow you down, you're just like, yeah, it's going to be uncomfortable because you're not used to being in this position. But after a time, you're going to be like, oh, I get it. And the body just naturally, like, it naturally rewards you for being patient and taking a step back. And you're going to feel stronger like this. That's the beauty of athletes, right? We have an awareness with our bodies that the majority of people that are in our daily lives don't have. You know what I mean? So it's important to take a step back from the dance and work on what your body's been asking you to do.
Gotcha.
So
check out his video clips on some common exercises and also explanations of things within our dance that you should look at and consider when you're trying to do certain movements within our breaking. Also, he does assessments, and with those assessments, those are catered directly to you, the individual dancer. And we're working on a project to see how is it that we can get more people involved through the online community, to have them share, you know, some of their experiences and then give you as best advice, but to help gear you towards longevity within this dance, because that's the idea.
Yeah, so it's a huge key word, longevity. Yeah.
So I thank everybody for taking the time to just hear us out. Stay tuned for some more info.